Hello, I'm Paul Pluter from Paul Pluter Prestige, and today we've got a special treat. We're going to show you how we fully clean a piece once we buy it on the used market. And this is a Louis Vuitton President Classier and Monogram. I picked this up on eBay and it's just come in, and you can see me unwrapping it here. It's quite a nice piece in reasonably good condition. It's a monogram, which is the canvas. It's got a lot of brass work, which is hasn't got lacquer on it. This, on the hard case items, it's got proper brass with no lacquer on top of it. So we're going to give this a complete clean. We're going to give it a full clean so we can use it without other, you know, the previous remnants of the previous owner lingering on it. You know, just the smell and stuff like that there. So this is a Louis Vuitton President Classier. It's a hard case briefcase. And a lot of the cleaning principles that we use in this item here can be used for any other Louis Vuitton item. The only thing I'd emphasize is that here we've got proper brass without the lacquer. If you're cleaning brass that's got the lacquer on it, you want to just be a little bit treated a little bit differently. But the way you can tell, if it's got a lacquer on it, it probably doesn't need cleaning because it stays nice and shiny. Whereas if it's the traditional brass itself, it tarnishes, and you can clean it up with some brass cleaner. And this is quite a nice interior. It's quite a nice piece. And I've got to say, this was a bargain I bought on eBay. And at the moment, if you hunt around, there are some really great bargains popping up on eBay. And I offer an authentication service, so you can contact me at the channel, and for $10, $10, I'm happy to authenticate a piece. So if you're in doubt, you can ask the experts, myself, and you can get some really good bargains. This is about $5,000 new. And I picked this up for just over $1,000. Absolute bargain. And I don't think it's that old. I think this is probably only a couple years old. It hasn't had a lot of use. And I'm glad to add it to my collection. Okay, let's start. The first thing we're going to clean is the brassware. That's because the brass solution we use does leave some residue. So the first thing you want to do before you clean anything else is get some brass cleaner and start cleaning your brassware. Now, the best way to do it is do it slowly, 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 slowly. And here I'm using a cotton bud, just putting some solution on. I'm not dabbing solution everywhere. That's the worst thing you can do. Just put a little bit on, work on one piece at a time. And I know it's slow, I know it's a bit annoying, but hey, you want great results, you follow my advice. I'm the expert, I'm the world authority on Louis Vuitton, and you think I don't know how to clean this shit? So please, listen to the video, watch my advice, and let's go through the full cleaning process. So I'm just using some brass cleaner here, just getting rid of any little marks or blemishes on it. Just using a cotton bud to dab it on there and to clean it there. So it's just trying to make it not too bad there. Just got to be careful not to put too much solution here, because that'll leak into the monogram fabric. Now, after you've put it on, you let it stay there for a couple, probably about 5 to 20 seconds, and then just get an old cloth and just rub it off. It's good to get some nice, these are some old sheets that have worn, and I'm just taking the cream in it. Just look at that. Look how the results are starting to turn up. I haven't soaked it. I've just put a little bit on with a cotton bud, and look at the results I'm starting to achieve here. Now, the secret is, if it's really dirty, keep going over it again. You keep going over it, and that is going to remove the marks. Now, look at this here. This is pretty tarnished, and the results I'm getting here are coming up pretty nicely, and that's because I'm taking my time, I'm doing a little bit at a time, and I'm just applying the solution, and I'm just rubbing it off with a cotton cloth. Worn sheets are the best. Now here, you can see in the brass here, I've gone over it once already, but I'm going over it a second time. There's a little mark here in the brass. It's not a damage to the brass, but it's just a tarnish, probably a little bit of water got onto it, or a bit of sweats or something like that. And it's a little bit more tarnish there. So just apply it with a cotton bud, just do a little bit at a time, and you can't go wrong. And here we go, just going over it again, different section, just do it slowly, and just use a old cloth, you know, really nice and thick scrunch it all up and just buff it. And that's really the secret to getting your brassware to look brilliant. And I like a little bit of, it doesn't have to be absolutely every bit has to be spick and shiny. Just do the main bits and it starts to get a life of its own there. And on the handles, the two fasteners that hold the handle on, I noticed that's a different color brass, so I like to just not have that as polished as the other brass pieces, to sort of accent it, and just go over it again and again and again. That's the secret. And if you want your brassware to look beautiful, you've just got to be patient and do it slowly. There's no quick instant answer. You just very carefully approach the brass, and you can see here this is starting to turn out really nice. And look at that, there's some results for you to see. That's starting to really come there of age there. And this is the thing, you can, if you really want, you can keep going over it again and again and again. And sometimes it's good to have a break between when you do that and when you, you might just get a bit sick of it. Just don't do it. You know, just take a break and come back to it. You know, that's always a good way to go. I'm just showing you this briefcase here. We're doing a complete 360, so you can see every bit of this fabulous item, and just see how I've done the brassware. So look at that there; it's all looking beautiful, and the locks are done. Look at that; they're absolutely stunning. And also, don't forget to flip it the other way and polish in the crevices there. And I think I've got some pretty nice results here. I like it. I think this is starting to look nice. This is what I like in it. I like it to be fairly shiny, but it doesn't have to be every intricate bit. So, there you go. That's the result. This has probably taken me about an hour to do. And I'll even get the keys done. Okay, let's go on to cleaning the briefcase. The best thing I use is just some soapy. I'll show you the soapy. It's a Dettol solution. I just get a sponge and I completely rub the outside with a sponge, and what I'm doing there is that's just getting rid of any grime and dirt and gunk on it. And also here I'm just getting the same soapy stuff here to go over, and that's getting rid of any of the brass cleaning solution that I use there. After I've done that, I get a wet cloth, a really wet cloth. Just cold water is fine, doesn't have to be warm. It can be warm, but not hot. I don't like hot. And then I'm just giving it a complete wipe over to get rid of any soapy residue that is left on the piece there. So just giving it a complete wipe over with a really damp cloth. And after that, get a dry cloth. These are three separate cloths or things here, and this is a completely dry cloth, and I'm just drying it all. You've got to try and dry it as soon as you can. You don't want the water to sit there for like an hour or so, because it can cause damage. Once you've washed it with soapy solution, then you've washed it with a really damp cloth, dry it, and that's always worked for me. Now I'm doing the interior same way there. I'm using that soap, which is a Dettol hand cream. That's all it is. It's Dettol foam soap. So, that's an antiseptic, and it's also, it just gets rid of any little mark or dust or stuff like that there. There we go. Dettol soap foam. We can get that variation of that all around the world. And then I'm using my really damp cloth to really vigorously get rid of all the soap and get any dust out of the crevices. And I'm also going to use a similar solution, just the soap there, to clean the handle. Now the handle, it's leather that's not treated, so just be a bit careful there. There we go. Now we're airing it out. Must air it out. Always look at that. I've put it on the sofa there, so it's got a pillow, so even underneath it's getting nice airing out. You want to let it air out for a while. And once you've aired it out there, you can then start using the item. I'm Paul Pluta from Paul Pluta Prestige. I hope you've enjoyed this Louis Vuitton clean.